Hi, I'm Rachel Donegan. I am the Howe Library's Emerging Technologies Librarian, and I am here to show you how to make something every week. This is Howe Makers.
Hi, today I'm in Studio H, which is the Howe Library's digital media studio in the lower level of the library. And today we're going to talk about our Glowforge laser cutter. So we have a Glowforge laser cutter. It's a 40-watt CO2 laser that can cut, engrave, or score a number of different materials. And once we are open again and patrons can come in, you can work on a project and cut it on our laser cutter.
Here are two projects I made earlier. These earrings were made out of cherry hardwood. Very simple, very quick to make those. And this box was also made on the laser. It was cut out using a box generator, and then I scored the logo in the front.
So people often ask me what materials can go into the laser, and a number of materials can be cut in the laser, and a lot more materials can also be engraved. So something like slate or ceramic tile, you can engrave even though the laser won't cut through it. Other materials like leather or plywood or hardwood, as long as it's cut very thin, no more than a quarter inch, the laser can cut it. So this material here is a proof grade material, which means it was purchased from Glowforge, it's been tested, and using this code right here, the laser can automatically set the settings for engraving, cutting, and scoring. So these materials make it really easy to do a project very quickly. You can also use your own materials, so things you can buy at a local store can go in the machine as well.
Here is our Glowforge laser cutter. And I just turned it on, so it's going through its warm-up setup procedure here, and I have a piece of material already in the Glowforge that we are going to cut a design on in just a minute. And we also have a filter right here, which is very good because the Glowforge produces a fair amount of smoke and fumes, and we are able to vent using the filter even though we don't have any windows or outside access to ventilation. The design software that I use with the Glowforge here in Studio H is called Inkscape, and it's a free download. It's available for Mac or PC. It's very powerful, and it creates vector files, which are the only kinds of files that you can cut on the laser. You can engrave other kinds of files, but to cut or score, you have to have a scalable vector format graphic. So I just mocked up this little design right here, and we're going to put this into the laser. And I've made it different colors because different operations require it. So what's going to happen, there's three colors in this image. There's a gray here and here. Those are going to be cut out. This one, the text here is black, which I believe I am going to engrave, but I'm leaving it open to change my mind if I want to score it instead. And then this acorn is red. So it doesn't matter what the colors are, but as long as they're different colors, I can tell the laser to treat each element differently.
Here we are in the Glowforge user interface. The Glowforge is actually completely cloud-based. So what we're seeing on my laptop here is an image that the laser is taking using the camera inside the lid of the material we have in there. And I have just imported my design right here. And I'm going to, all I can do in the user interface for the most part is resize and move it around. I can't do a lot of designing at this point. I've already designed it in Inkscape. I've brought it into the laser user interface, and I'm gonna move it down. I'm gonna move it down here. And I kind of like that size. That seems to be a reasonable size to me. And you can see over here, we get to choose what happens to each of the elements. So I'm going to cut that. I'm gonna actually change this to engrave. And that is going to also engrave. So this is very easy to do because we're using proof grade materials. If we had our own materials, we'd have to go in here and set our own manual settings, but we don't have to do that today. So let's see if we are ready to go. It looks like everything is set to go. So all we have to do now is hit this print button. All right, so this job is going to take 3 minutes and 16 seconds. Thank you.
So our design is all done. Now we just have to raise up the lid. Just going to push that out of the way. And there is our, that little part fell out. There is our design. Very nice. Only took 3 minutes and 16 seconds. And one thing nice about proof grade material is it comes with this masking on top. So this is to protect the wood from this sort of burny, smoky residue that happens when you laser cut something. So we're going to go take that off and then we will see our finished design. Thanks so much for joining me here in Studio H. Hopefully you have some great ideas for some projects that you can do with the laser cutter, and we can meet up hopefully sometime soon to work on those projects. See you next time. Bye.